As Morpheus my senses enslumbered in drown, I dreamt I was climbing up Horeb's holy mount, where Moses was chosen grandmaster of love by the great architect in heaven above. In trembling fear and wonder, I stood all in amaze to see a bush burn in all my mighty blaze. My bones they did shudder, and quite feeble was my frame, till a dreadful fiery serpent right forward to me came. Now I looked on death approaching with terror, dread, and grief, then called on goodness to grant me some relief. When, to my great astonishment, a voice unto me said, "Come, take you up the serpent, and do not be afraid." I then became a pilgrim to travel night and day. I took the rod of God with me to guide me on my way, o'er high hills and mountains, bound for the temple bright, till I came unto Jerusalem, that city of delight. There I saw the knights of Malta in shining armor bright surround the sons of darkness that cast away the light. That flushed feathered pheasant that gave the signal call, that did deny the Savior, the Redeemer of us all. There were many warlike heroes that struck me with surprise, until a greater wonder then approached my ravished eyes. A grand illumination before me then appeared, in the form of an ancient warrior who wore a noble beard. Now his robes were long and beautiful, and rich with honor glowed, and the golden helmet on his head his regal honor showed. 12 dazzling stars of luster all on his royal breast, with the sword of justice in his hand, with sparkling gem and crest. He enlisted me as a soldier to fight for Christian liberty against the Turk and heathen and all idolatry. To all our faithful battles Jehovah lent a hand, to Gideon brave and Joshua who caused the sun to stand. Now through Sharon's lovely valley and great Mount Gerizim high, Mount Calvary lay mourning as I was passing by. I crossed the river Jordan and Jericho likewise, to lovely Mount Zion, where sweet odors scent the skies. I traveled o'er Mount Ararat and fair Armeria's land, from thence to Enoch's temple, where I saw two pillars grand. Now the one was marble in the east, the other brazen pure, with a carved stone of jasper that closed up the door. Though I knocked upon the jasper gates, admittance there I sought, through many colored arches till I found that sacred vault. With torches burning round me in one continuous blaze, till I saw the sacred mystery, and on it carefully gazed. I fell upon my knees and offered up a prayer to all goodness and mercy with fervency and care, when to my great astonishment two fiery dragons came, and at the height of my surprise I woke out of my dream.